We have been visiting rural parishes. This is the first time I've been in the town setup. Maybe that's why we make an opportunity to comment on the mission. But we want to say, as a country, this is a very, very critical year for Kenyans. This is a year that we are deciding at the ballot who the next dispensation of leadership are going to be. Our democracy demands that we do party primaries because we are a multi-party state, and we are so sorry for the state the country is going through because of the shambled primary elections, which indicate that our coalitions and political parties are not prepared, and there is a lot of display of non-democracy being displayed in each of the major coalitions. Jubilee is not safe on this. NASA is not safe on this. People are crying out there that they have not been given opportunity to elect the people they are supposed to elect freely. There has been an indication of ballot boxes already touched with the papers, and this has led into a lot of a shambles and chaotic scenario which we have seen. So I, as one of the church leaders in this country, are calling for sobriety among the Kenyan people as we go towards election, and beginning with this primary. This is the beginning of the test of our democracy. We know that our democracy is young, but the way we are looking at it, it's like we are retrogressing instead of progressing to become a full democracy. What we are praying for are free, credible, fair elections come August the 8th, 2017. And if we can't get it right at the primaries, in the individual coalition parties which are competing, then it becomes very, very worrisome what will happen during the August time. So it is our call, as we condemn for the any act of lawlessness. We have seen ballot boxes being banned, and it is our call to every of those people who are following political leaders and followers of the political parties to exercise tolerance, because there will be no democracy.